So welcome all. Today we'll be discussing the remaining parts of the class Phaeophysae, that is the brown algae. The protoplast coming to the inside of the cell, except the cell wall, the protoplast what we call, the protoplast is composed of all types of various organelles and consists of other chromatophores like violoxanthin, fucoxanthin, flavoxanthin, beta-carotenoid and other chlorophyll pigments. Cytoplasm also contains fucoxone vesicles which are called as refractive bodies. And one of the main characters of these Phaeophysae members is that genetically we can differentiate the X and Y chromosomes, that is the male and female plant body or the thallus can be very easily differentiated. Now coming to the reproduction of the Phaeophysae members. All forms of reproduction is present in Phaeophysae members, may it be sexual, asexual or parthenogenesis. All three can be seen in this Phaeophysae members, also the vegetative one. The vegetative reproduction takes place through fragmentation. The plant body fragments itself into many fragments because of various reasons, or may it be environmental or due to plant or human or animal interventions. So these fragmented bodies regerminate into a whole new thallus. Asexual reproduction is found in all members of Phaeophysae except in case of fucus and sargassum. Both motile and non-motile spores are found in this mode of reproduction. But these different spores are, that is the non-motile and the motile spores are found in different types of sporangia. So the different types of sporangia are unilocular sporangia being the first one. So in this unilocular sporangia you can find 4 to 128 biflagellate zoospores, and are these spores produced in the unilocular sporangia are haploid in nature, that is the set of chromosomes is only n in number, that is single in number. So coming to the second types of sporangia, that is the plurilocular sporangia or the neutral sporangia. These neutral sporangia are produced in multicellular 2N plants, that is the sporophytic generation of the Phaeophysae members. These zoospores are formed in large number which are 2N in ploidy, that is two sets of chromosomes are found in the spores. These are formed due to the mitotic divisions, and since the consistency of the chromosome number remains 2N throughout this production of spores in the plurilocular type of sporangia, this is called as neutral type of sporangia. And coming to the third type of sporangia, that is the tetrasporangia, is found in only few members of Phaeophysae. In this type of sporangia, that is unilocular in nature, only diploid plants produce meiotically four spores, in which two spores out of spores, four spores produce male thallus, and two out of the four produce female thallus. Now coming to the sexual reproduction, the plant body is haploid except in few cases. Hence in the gametophytic generation of Phaeophysae, both all the three, that is isogamy, anisogamy and oogamy, can be found. Male sex organs, that is the antheridia, it may be unicellular or multicellular depending upon the orders, that is from the ectocarpals to the fucales. So the female sex organs are oogonia, are invariably unicellular in all the cases, may it be Phaeophysae or any other classes. So the fertilization of the antheridia and oogonia may take place in the external environment or inside the thallus itself. So the internal fusion, that is the fusion of antheridia and oogonia inside the female thallus itself. So the fertilization of the antheridia and oogonia inside the thallus itself is called as in situ fertilization. Fertilization may be in case of fucales is external, where the male and female antheridia and oogonia are discharged into the water. Occasionally parthenogenesis can also be seen, which is the development of the thallus from the oogonia itself without fertilization. So coming to the life cycle, that is the last aspect of the Phaeophysae. Life cycle is mainly alternation in generation. only alternation of generation is seen in the life cycle of phaeophyce. That is one phase, that is two phases, that is sporophytic phase and gametophytic phase can be seen alternatively to each other in the life cycle of the phaeophyce members. Sporophytic generation is N in ploidy, that is the plant thallus will be of single set of chromosome, and in the second, that is the gametophytic generation, this plant body will be, the plant thallus will be of 2N ploidy. So these alternation of generation also can be classified into two types. Depending upon the size of the plants, two types of generation can be said in the alternative form of generation. That is, one is the isomorphic and the other one is the heteromorphic alternation of generation. If the size of the two generations, that in the sporophytic and the gametophytic, is same or similar, then it is called as isomorphic alternation of generation. If the size of the gametophyte and the sporophyte is different in both the cases of sporophytic and gametophytic generation, it is called as heteromorphic alternation of generation. So one of the another peculiar character is in the phaeophyce members, of mainly in that of Fucales, is that they exhibit cyclosporic life cycle. That is, the sporophyte itself contains the gametes. Hence, there is no differentiation in thallus of that of sporophyte and the gametophyte. Hence, it is called as cyclosporic type of life cycle. Thank you.